Attention, eggheads. I'm Juan Carlos Bagnell for Newegg Studios, and this is a new CPU alert. Cue the sirens! Sorry, I couldn't help myself there. This week, AMD debuted three new CPUs as part of an extension to the Ryzen 3000 lineup. The new additions are the Ryzen 9 3900 XT, the Ryzen 7 3800 XT, and the Ryzen 5 3600 XT. And we're going to take just a few minutes to tell you what you need to know about the newest processors out on the market. First, these new XT CPUs are not a full new generation from AMD. Instead, they're more like an upgrade to some of the existing Ryzen 3000 models, optimized with higher boost frequencies to deliver moderately improved performance at different tiers. This means that these new CPUs do not require new motherboards, though they have released pretty close to the full lineup of new B550 boards from the major manufacturers. The 3000 XT CPUs use the AM4 platform and are officially compatible with B450, B550, and X570 motherboards. And in fact, it looks like these new CPUs will even work in older 300 and 400 series AMD boards, though all compatibility is dependent on having the latest BIOS. Now, we have heard directly from AMD that the next official generation of CPUs from the company will be the Zen 3 Ryzen 4000 models. And CEO Dr. Lisa Su herself has said we should see those before the end of 2020. So these XT CPUs aren't those yet. This is more of a mid-generation refresh and update kind of thing. Now, a freshened up version of the processors that have been on sale for a while now may not seem like a siren-worthy update, but the new XT lineup shows AMD refining the technology and processes that made third-gen Ryzen such a success. A clock boost of 100 MHz both for base and turbo speeds is a small improvement, but AMD claims that the new processors will be able to maintain the boost clock speeds for longer, giving you better power and stability over time. Add to that improved communication speeds between cores, and you can see AMD really just tightening everything up. Are they better than the current AMD lineup? Sure. But are they worth upgrading to if you already have a Zen 2 Ryzen chip? With Zen 3 coming at the end of the year on the Ryzen 4000 chips, it seems like a pretty hard sell. But if you're in the market for a new CPU right now, and you want to go with AMD, then you now have some more powerful options to choose from. Now let's talk about cooling. The base chip, the Ryzen 5 3600 XT, comes with a Wraith Spire cooler in the box. But according to AMD, the rest of the chips forego in-the-box coolers because they know real gamers like to use more robust aftermarket coolers. They recommend AIOs of at least 280 millimeters or an air cooler with similar horsepower to keep your CPU temps in the ideal range while putting it through its paces. So who are these processors for? Well, if you're already considering an AMD processor for an upcoming build, these are going to be better, more refined versions of the chips you were already considering. They take what makes AMD's current Ryzen series so popular, like their ability to handle multi-threaded workflows of game streaming or content creation better than equivalent Intel chips, and turn the dial up on that performance a click or two. And with their awesome performance per dollar, they make a compelling argument. The Ryzen 5 3600 XT has an MSRP of $249, the Ryzen 7 3800 XT is listed at $399, and the beastly Ryzen 9 3900 XT will go for $499. Obviously, with the potential popularity of these new CPUs, stock limitations mean that prices and availability are subject to change. Are you planning on using the new AMD Ryzen XT processors in an upcoming build? Or maybe you found them compelling enough to upgrade your existing rig? Let us know in the comments below. For Newegg Studios, I'm Juan Carlos Bagnell. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch y'all on the next video.